Problem is to write a Python program to convert two lists into a dictionary. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain, and in this video we will learn how to write a program that will allow us to convert two lists into a dictionary. Guys, in our Python there are two methods. Our first method is with the help of our zip function and dictionary methods, and our second method is by using the zip function along with the list comprehension method. So we will be looking at both of them one by one. Let's have a look on how it can be done. So guys, as I said, solution one is using the zip function and the dictionaries method. So we need to convert the list into a dictionary. For converting a list into a dictionary, we need two lists. Why two lists are required? Because we want to pass keys and the values. In a dictionary, inside a pair, we have a key and a value. So for our keys, we have name, and for our values, we have marks. Okay. So name is John and the marks would be 98, Peter 78, Lisa 88 and David 72. Now how do I make a pair of them? To make a pair, I will be using a zip function. Now how to use the zip function is very simple. You can create any variable. Suppose I'm creating a dictionary, a variable called as dictionary. In here, I'll be using a zip function. What zip function will do? It will iterate in both the list one by one. So I'll be passing both of them. I'll be passing the name and the marks as well. So it will iterate inside both of them one by one and create a pairs in the form of a tuple. But we don't need a tuple, we need a dictionary, right? So while printing, what we will do, we will write dict to convert the data type into dictionary. And then we will write dictionary here. So if I run it, I'll get the output in this way that we have John 98, Peter 78, Lisa 88 and David 72, which is what we wanted in the first place, that we converted the two lists in the format of a dictionary by using the zip function and the dictionary method. What is the dictionary method over here is very simple, that we have written dict in front of the dictionary. That means whatever output we have got after using the zip function, in front of it you need to put dictionary so that it gets converted into dictionary. So I hope guys that the solution one is clear over here. In our solution two, we will be talking about the zip function and the list comprehension method. So for our solution two, again, I'm taking the two lists because obviously we need two lists over here. And what I'll be doing, I'll be again creating a variable called as dictionary. Now, because I'll be using a list comprehension method, we will not be using the square brackets, but because we want to obtain the dictionary, that's why we will be using the braces here. And because we want to, inside the dictionary, we want key and value pairs. So I'll be writing key, colon, value. You can write any other variable name as well, but I am writing key and value. For key, comma, value in, and again we will be creating a zip of marks and name. So I'll be writing zip, and inside I'll be passing name, comma, marks. Here we don't need to put a parentheses, so we can just directly write zip and name and marks. Now let's print our dictionary. So once I run it, I'll get the output John 98, Peter 78, Lisa 88, David 72. If I would have written marks first and name later, then in that case, so if I would have written in this way, not without a colon, but with a comma. And let's run it again. So if I run it, this time the marks are the keys and the name is the value. So you can swap if you want to. So method is very simple over here, that again we use the zip function to iterate inside it, and we have written key and value, that for key value in zip marks comma name, we need to obtain key colon value, and then we have printed the dictionary. So I hope guys that both the methods over here are clear. In our first method, we use the zip function along with the dictionary method. And in our second solution, we use the zip function along with the list comprehension method. The link of this code is present in our description. And for more such interesting programs, stay connected guys. Thank you.